terror neighbors make our lives hell. Returned the favor by getting them raided. As we found out that we'd be expecting not one but two kids, we knew we had to move to a real house with more space. At the time we were still living in a one-bedroom studio one up from the ground floor, with its only entrance being a metal fire escape stairs. Not ideal for a pregnant woman, let alone to live with two small babies. So, we found a privately leased house that was newly renovated and had all the room and a large garden we were looking for. Signed the lease and immediately collected the keys. As the owner drove off, the woman next door comes up to me, immediately demanding we not make noise before noon as her BF works nights and sleeps and a whole bunch of other do's and don'ts. So right off the bat knew, trouble incoming. As the house was fully renovated and not much had to be done, we were like, don't poke the bear, we'll do the things that make noise after noon. We moved in after 2 weeks and the whole street was warm and welcoming. My wife was almost due giving birth to my twin daughters and some of her help with anything we needed, real kind people. They also told us about our neighbors. Nobody liked them. He was a big bully and got into arguments with everybody. Also were known as Radio Pirates as an illegal broadcasting on radio with all Dutch bangers. This music is just terror on your ears and possibly used on terrorists on black sites, which went alongside them partying Thursday Sunday till 5 in the morning. Loud music, constant yelling, always drunken etc. Really something to look forward to when moving in, certainly with two babies on the way. The partying began immediately, full blast. Real classy for someone demanding to be quiet when douchebag needs his beauty sleep. Then one day my father-in-law came to put new grass in. He has his trailer parked at the back of our houses, which is public space. Not according to him though, know that exact spot where the trailer are, full with grass, sods, quite heavy stuff, was parked was his spot and we had to move the trailer. Not going to happen as I was not planning to walk all the way around the house with the sods. He gets angry right away and demanded me to move it. I told him to go F himself. I was done with him already then and there. I'm also a ginger, so besides having no soul, I do have a temper which is always in check until you provoke me repeatedly. Anyone who knows me will tell you that you really had to make an effort for that to happen. We went on working and end of day comes when my father-in-law wants to leave. Hooks up the trailer and bam, there was douchebag, telling him off, yelling it's his spot and he better does not do this again or else. Mess with me all you want, I can handle it, but what you don't do is threaten my family. I ran outside and told him in no uncertain terms to back off or he'll be the sorry one. Total bluff on my side. Yes, I have that temper, but I'm not impressively built and have no hidden fighting skills. I do fight dirty. He backs off, father-in-law leaves and I go inside where I find my wife crying. She got scared of him maybe doing something to her father and or me, and this is something we don't need right now. Combined with hormones from being pregnant and you can paint that picture. So I'm even more pissed but had to promise not to act on anything. I won't, dear, not yet anyway. Time went on without any real incident and then came the time my wife goes into labor. Didn't go smooth and ended up having to deliver with C-section, or whatever it's called, because daughter 2 was almost strangled by the umbilical cord. We had to stay 3 nights, excruciating nights due to a lot of things. Finally we get to go home. Family had put a giant sign in our front yard welcoming the babies. The sign was already up for a few days prior to coming home, so our friendly neighbors definitely knew about it. But did they give a flying if? No. They did not. From the first night on they started to party and broad blasted their terror music. They started at noon and continued to until 5 or 6 in the morning. Classy. They also kept going for days. So it wasn't just Thursday Sunday, it was all week long and the next. So we were broken, hardly slept. One of our daughters suffered from heavy cramps combined with all the noise and her parents at the end of their wits, so she cried a lot. And then I just had it. I researched some things on Radio Pirates, the laws and regulations, and on his large, 5 meters plus antenna in his backyard, which was illegal in itself, but he used it to illegally broadcast on radio, which meant he had a lot of equipment to do so, which was even more illegal and can even get you jailed, but at the very least they could seize it or and fine him big time. in the 10 to 45,000 area. Now, I did not immediately turn him in but instead were looking for another house to lease first. This because I figured it wouldn't sit well with him and having a wife and two babies in the house alone during the day because I had to go to work. I hear you guys thinking, why not involve the police? Well, they are utterly useless in cases like this. We called once and what they did disturbs me to this day. They rang at their doorbell and immediately started off by saying we called them about noise complaints. Yes, you read that right. No protection or whatsoever, just blatantly told them we were the reason they're there, told them to keep it down and that was it. They didn't even follow up with us or anything. As you can guess, douchebag now was even more pissed and told me the next day, or yelled over the fence that separates our backyards that I really should not do that again, a threat yet again of which I told the police. I didn't report it the first time as I chalked that up to alpha male and heat of the moment. But without witnesses to corroborate, nothing could be done yet again. Some days later I walked out the front door and he just stepped out of his car. Came up to me demanding I cut back some of our ivy that grew on our side of the fence because it tangled in with his big ass antenna. He would be gone for some hours and I could come into his garden to cut back the ivy that grew through on their side. And then a light bulb went on above my head. I told him politely that I would do that immediately. Why? Because that gave me the opportunity to find out the make and model of this antenna to ascertain its signal strength, where the cables go exactly and what kind of cables they were, again to know the signal strength it handled. Also, it gave me a good view on the equipment he had, through the window so I could snap some photographs of it. This was the icing on the cake. Because in the meantime we did manage to find a new home and already had signed the lease so we would be gone in 2 weeks. Luckily we only had to paint some walls for the girl's room and furthermore just pack up our things and move them to the other house. So after I trimmed the ivy and collected my evidence I went online that night to find out the proper channels to report a broadcast pirate and which entity was tasked with catching said pirate. Turned out I had to call the telecom agency but also the police. Wasn't too happy with the latter but I remembered I have a nephew that works for the police. Officially his area was immigration but knew enough colleagues that could help us and we could trust not to confront them again saying I was the one that sent them. That was extremely important for our safety when doing what I was doing. So I gave both the agency and the police all evidence I collected, pointed them to the frequencies he pirated so they could listen in. Then they started a neighborhood investigation, which wasn't really necessary but this was to cover our asses to make it look like he got caught by accident because they had an active investigation in our area. You never know what he can learn from legal documents and such. We asked them to wait with the raid. Yes, they raid pirates' houses, preferably in the early hours of the day because of his beauty sleep rendering him incapable of fleeing or hide evidence etc. We moved 2 weeks later and they raided him 2 days after we moved. All of his equipment, computers, radios, cell phones and his car were seized. He left in cuffs, his wife slash girlfriend did too, for making a big scene and tried to interfere. All of which was live reported to me by one of my ex-neighbors who were equally ecstatic about this. It turned out, this wasn't the first time he got caught but his third time. His car had no insurance on it and his mo failed. This would normally have no big consequence because he didn't drive it while raided, but they had the guy surveilled on for a week and that definitely meant he was seen driving it while not having insurance and valid mo. He was fined somewhere around €30,000, went to jail for 12 weeks and everything seized was destroyed except the car. His girlfriend had to do 40 some hours community service. They had to sell the house, which made for very happy neighbors as they too were over and done with them. Like I said, I do fight, but very dirty. You have to really make an effort for me to get to that point. They did and suffered. Over a year later when shopping groceries I encountered them. With the foulest of looks, if looks could kill I'd be a smoldering heap of ash. But nothing more than that. Damn folks, kind of surprised about all the appreciation. Gold and silver awards. Wholesome, masterpiece, helpful, bravo grand and so many upvotes. Thank you all, kind people. I honestly do not know what I can do with gold or silver but I promise you I'll spend it by giving back. This shit period in our lives turns into something better this way.